our itinerary, well, didn't add this, but I had to put this thing in for you to see where Accra starts from and where it's going. So coming up is a lighthouse. If you look, I'm gonna go down a bit. See the lighthouse on our right? Okay, so the British built this lighthouse. It was recently refurbished in, the last refurbishment was in 1920s. And yes, and if you look down, there's a fishing village. The lighthouse still works. The fishermen use it as well. When they go fishing, they do that. And then also coming up on this very wall is the James Fort Prison. It was also the James Fort Dungeons. This place, our first president was arrested, including the people, we call them the Big Six, were put here in this prison. But now it's no more a prison. Because one of the previous governments said this prison is too close to the city. So you had to move it out. So this is British Accra. This is British Accra. So when the British came to Accra in 1877, this is where they settled. British Accra. So old Accra. And so all these buildings on your left were warehouses that they used. When the British moved to Accra, they built a railway system in 1924-25. They built a railway system from the middle belt, that's around the Asante region and the western region where we have much cocoa. So to come to the port and then ship. So down there was a port as well. So were built, and some of these were warehouses that these cocoa beans were stored and kept. But these were also indigenous home for the Gaan people. So the Gaan people live here. Yes, and there are various chiefs. We crossed by one of the chief palace here. It's called Gaan Machine. So we are still in British Accra. Very soon there's just a road, a crossroad that separates the British Accra from the Dutch Accra. And also the Dutch built a fort. They call it the Usher Fort. Yes, before, or the other name, the Dutch name was called Fort Krivoke. And before the British came here, the Dutch were already here. And then also, right here, when slavery was abolished in Brazil, there were some Africans who were sent there who wanted to come back to Africa. So in this town, part of this wall, there was a place called Brazil House. They are called the Tabun people, Tabun, in Brazil. They moved and they came to settle here. Now they intermarried with the people here in Accra or in Jamestown, and they've mixed. And so it's one of the things. Jamestown is very popular for one, when it comes to entertainment, when it comes to sports. Second sports in Ghana is boxing. And so one of the famous boxers called Azuma Nelson.
Yeah.
Azuma Nelson is a descendant of Brazilian. The Brazilian slaves were sent to Brazil and came back to Africa. Yes, and so he's
a champion.
Yes, he was a champion, yes.
Is it true that Africa was named after a European? It wasn't originally called Africa? Is that, or do you know?
No, I don't know. Yes, and then we also have other boxers who actually come from here called Aikote. And then in entertainment, there was a famous dance that came called Azonto.
Yes.
Yes, it originated from Jamestown here. Yes, and so we've crossed British Accra. We are now in Dutch Accra, and this is the fort that was built by the Dutch. And all these forts were built as warehouses later on during the transatlantic slave trade, were converted into dungeons. And then when the British took over and slavery was abolished, they were all converted into prisons.
From one prison to another.
Sounds quite familiar.
Yeah. Right. You know, it sounds like some white people do.
Sounds quite familiar. Yeah.
So this is old Accra. Yes, and so when we go further on, we're actually entering into the business district of Accra. We're gonna see the central bank of Accra and all that. One interesting thing about here, whenever as in August, we celebrate the biggest street art festival now. It's called the Chalowote Festival. That's why you see murals on the walls and paintings on the wall. People from all over come here to demonstrate art and creativity. So this is to promote the place. It's, you know, the sad thing is every government have tried to develop old Accra, but anytime they come, they neglect the place. That's a sad thing. Yeah. And so very soon we'll be at the Kwame Nkrumah Memorial Park, or Kwame Nkrumah Mausoleum. Kwame Nkrumah formed the first political party. But fast forward, I told you right after the Second World War, a lot of things happened. So 47, first political party was formed. 48, this is what happened. This road we're driving on is called the 28th February Road. 28th February Road. This road connects all the way to one of the castles that was built by the Swedish, took over by the Danish, and then later on sold to the British. So later on, the British used that place as the administrative capital. So before they went for the war, the people were promised. The soldiers were promised that if they go and fight, by the time they come back, they will be compensated. Good health care, paid and all that. And when they came, nothing happened. So three people were actually guards from Jamestown, were marching to the castle to present a petition to the governor to demand what he had been promised. And they got to a crossroad where they were shot and killed. And this, you could imagine, sparked riots, confusion, looting, and all that happened. This was a major catalyst that moved that Ghana should have independence. So when that happened, six men, if you look on our currents, you see six heads on them. We call them the Bixes, they are founding fathers. They were arrested, if you look here. They were arrested and put into the James prison. And then later on, because there were moves, political party was formed, were moved to have election, to have a representative in the Parliament House. I'll show you the Parliament House, right? Wake up close. And so Kwame Nkrumah's party won in 1951. He became the first African person to represent Ghanaians here. All black, in all white parliament. And so Kwame Nkrumah moved the motion for Ghana's independence. Before I continue, if you look on your right, on your left, sorry, that's the Central Bank of Ghana, Bank of Ghana. Individuals can do business there, it's only government. Yeah. So when that happened, Kwame Nkrumah and all these men were arrested. Kwame Nkrumah was released when he won the election. And then also, when he was released, when he won the election.
He won the election.
Yes. He won it, just like Nelson Mandela.
Yeah, that's gangster.
And so that happened. Okay, so this white building here you see on your left is actually the Judiciary Service. We have the Supreme Court here. And also the previous Parliament House is next, close by it. You see the beams, the British architecture. And the sad thing is our judges and our lawyers have to go in that white wig.
Rock on with your bad self and that right wig on.
Ain't it black?
Yes, in their black gown.
Can't they change it?
Why can't they change it?
I don't know.
You don't know.
Yeah, so again, Kwame Nkrumah was a great person. He's actually been accredited as one of the greatest leaders in the world. A few things I'll talk to you about. Just a minute, I need to open the place for us to enter.